Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to create partitions using the AOMEI Partition Assistant. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to create a new partition on your hard drive or SSD, you can just follow these steps. Now to create a new partition, you can either select this disk here and then click on Quick Partition, which will take you to this screen, where it's basically going to pre-allocate some partitions for you for your software, documents, fun, and all that other stuff. And by default, it'll create 5 partitions for this drive that I have selected, but you can also click on this button here and then only make this 1 partition. You can also change the disk type from MBR to GPT or vice versa, and disable or enable any of these other options. Now, generally, I recommend just leaving all of these options on default if you don't know what all of them do. And then once you're ready, you can just click on Start Partitioning. But for now, I'm just going to cancel out of this and show you how to create the partition manually. Now, instead of selecting the disk, you can select this unallocated space on the disk. And then over here, you can click on Create Partition. Now, if you only want to have 1 partition, you can just leave it on the default partition size. You can change the drive letter if you like. And then you can also change the file system. I'll just leave this on NTFS. But here you can see all of the other file systems that you can also choose. I'm just going to select NTFS, and if you click on advanced, you can also find some other settings here, like you can give this partition a name. I'll just call this external one. This will automatically be created as a primary partition because it's the first partition. And for all of these other settings, I recommend just leaving this on the default and then clicking on OK. Now to create that partition, we'll have to click on apply. So I'm going to go ahead and click on apply and then click on proceed. And click on yes to start the operation. Now that it's finished, I'm just going to click on OK, and it's just going to reload the disks once again. And then we'll see, if we scroll down on this page here and we have a look at disk number 3, we can now see that we have 1 partition on it called external 1. So I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video, and I'll talk to you guys soon.